This webinar series discusses key findings from the School Nutrition and Meal Cost Study. This webinar focuses on findings related to school meal costs and food service revenues. The first webinar in the series provides an overview of the study, and four other webinars present key findings related to school meal program operations, compliance with the updated nutrition standards and the nutritional quality of school meals, dietary intakes of school meal participants and non-participants, and satisfaction with school meals and plate waste. Starting in school year 2012-13, the school meal programs began to undergo widespread changes, including updated nutrition standards for meals, additional lunch reimbursement for meals that met the standards, and rules affecting the price charged for full price lunches. The School Nutrition and Meal Cost Study collected data in school year 2014-15 and was the first comprehensive national assessment of the programs since these major reforms began. To provide the data needed to estimate meal costs, school staff provided information on the foods used in school meals for one school week, as well as all non-reimbursable food sales for the same week. Non-reimbursable food sales include foods sold a la carte or in vending machines operated by the Foodservice Department and meals sold to adults. Other information about costs of running the Foodservice program were collected from interviews with SFA and school staff, SFA financial statements, and food price data. The final analysis sample included 877 schools and 284 SFAs. We examined meal costs and revenues from several perspectives. In this webinar, we focus on estimates at the SFA level, which reflect costs for the typical or average SFA. We also focus on the reported costs of producing school lunches and breakfasts. From the SFA's perspective, reported costs are the costs of running the food service operation that they expect to be able to pay for from the food service account. We also present findings on total food service revenues at the SFA level, which include revenues from all sources. For the average SFA in school year 2014-15, it cost $3.81 to produce a school lunch and $2.72 to produce a school breakfast. The average SFA spent more to produce a school lunch than the average federal reimbursement for a free lunch, an average cost of $3.81 compared to an average reimbursement of $3.32. The average USDA reimbursement of $3.32 includes the reimbursement SFAs receive for free lunches, as well as the cash value of USDA foods used by the SFA. The same pattern was observed for school breakfast, where the average cost was $2.72 and the average federal reimbursement was $1.88. This figure shows the composition of SFA's costs for producing a school lunch. Food costs and labor costs accounted for the majority of the average SFA's cost. Each accounted for 45% of costs in the average SFA. Food costs include both purchased foods and USDA foods. Labor costs include salaries, wages, and fringe benefits for food service staff. Other direct costs constituted 10% of costs per school lunch. These may include costs related to non-food supplies, equipment purchases, utilities, and food service management company charges. The remaining 1% of costs were for indirect costs, which include services provided by the district, such as use of facilities or administrative support. The composition of costs for producing a school breakfast was nearly identical, and in general, the composition of costs for producing school meals has not changed since the last time USDA studied this issue in school year 2005-06. The average cost of producing a school lunch increased significantly between school year 2005-06 and school year 2014-15. For the average SFA, it cost $3.03 in inflation-adjusted dollars to produce a school lunch in 2005-06 compared to $3.81 in 2014-15. The average cost to produce a school breakfast also increased between the two points in time from $2.47 to $2.72, but the difference was not statistically significant. Next, we'll look at food service revenues. SFAs generate revenues from a number of sources. In school year 2014-15, USDA meal reimbursements accounted for 57% of the average SFA's revenues, and USDA foods accounted for 6%. So USDA subsidies accounted for almost two-thirds of SFA revenues. Student payments for school meals accounted for 20% of SFA revenues, and revenues from a la carte and other non-reimbursable food sales accounted for 11% of revenues. Funds provided by state and local government and other cash revenues accounted for much smaller shares of SFA revenues. There were some changes over time in the share of SFA revenues contributed by these different sources. Between school years 2005-06 and 2014-15, there was a significant increase in the share of SFA revenues attributable to USDA meal reimbursements, from 45% to 57%. This change is consistent with the increased reimbursement SFAs received for meals that met the updated standards, as well as an increase in the percentage of meals claimed at the higher free and reduced price rates. There was a significant decrease in the share of revenues obtained from student payments. This decline is directly related to the increase in the percentage of lunches served free or at a reduced price. There was also a significant decrease in revenues from a la carte and other non-reimbursable sales. This decrease is consistent with a decrease in the proportion of students who purchased a la carte and other non-reimbursable foods. SFAs work to balance the costs and revenues of the school meal programs to operate on a nonprofit basis. SFAs generally seek to break even, meaning that their revenues and costs are equal. For the average SFA in school year 2014-15, SFA revenues covered only 97% of their costs, meaning that their costs slightly outweighed their revenues. Or in other words, the average SFA operated at a small deficit. This figure shows the distribution of SFAs in terms of the extent to which their revenues covered their costs. Looking at the two light green bars, you can see that almost half of SFAs had revenues that covered between 95 and 105% of costs, that is, within 5 percentage points of the break-even point, where revenues equal costs. However, as shown in the light red bar, 14% of SFAs had revenues that covered between 90 and 95% of their costs, and 17% of SFAs, as shown in the dark red bar, had revenues that covered less than 90% of their costs. This slide provides a final perspective on the relationship between SFA costs and revenues. The figure shows the gap between the revenues SFAs receive from reimbursable meals and the costs of producing those meals. In the average SFA, revenues from reimbursable lunches, which include USDA meal reimbursements, USDA foods, state and local funds, and student payments, covered only 93% of the costs of producing those meals. The gap between revenues and costs was even larger for school breakfasts, with revenues from school breakfast covering only 82% of the costs of producing these meals. To minimize the gap between costs and revenues, the average SFA had to bring in revenue from other sources, most often a la carte and other non-reimbursable food sales. As shown on the right-hand side of this figure, in the average SFA, revenues from non-reimbursable food sales far exceeded the costs incurred for these foods. Revenues were about 152% of costs. This revenue surplus helped offset the extent to which SFA costs exceeded revenues from reimbursable meals. This finding differs from previous studies, which found that reimbursable meals were subsidizing non-reimbursable sales. In response, USDA established a rule on the pricing of a la carte and other non-reimbursable foods. Findings from the study provide evidence that the rule is working. More information on these findings, as well as findings for other study objectives, can be accessed on FNS's website using the link shown here. This includes the study reports, infographics, and additional webinars, including one that provides additional details on the methods used to estimate meal costs and revenues described in this webinar.